What's up, ladies and gents? Back again. I do apologize for being so scarce with regards to content and so on. I've been quite busy trying to finish off some work. We got some new work in as well. As far as the CRX K20 swap CRX goes, it's completed. Customer can come collect this car. We got ourselves a new build, Honda Ballard 4-door. Was previously B-Series, so I had the engine pulled out, and the car is at the paint shop as we speak. So at least it buys us some time to get hold of the parts. We have like maybe, let's say, 50% of the parts. So it's going to be K-Series. It's a K24 turbo all-wheel drive build. So I'll show you guys what it is that we have so far at the moment. Okay, so we got some sticky rubber Toyo Proxies. We got VMS wheels, drag wheels, 15-inch wheels. We have two at the moment, only we're still waiting on the other two to come in. And then over here, this is our, well, actually let me mount you guys up and then I'll go through all the boxes with you guys. Okay, so over here we've got ourselves a competition clutch. It's a twin disc. Some instructions. This is our release bearing alignment tool. So this is the complete clutch kit. So it comes with a flywheel, pressure plate, and then obviously twin discs. It's still sealed, obviously, so we don't get corrosion and so on. So we'll keep the seal until we assemble. And that is obviously for K24 or K20. Okay. This is our VMS wheels. I'm not going to lie, this is a pretty wheel. VMS Racing. So like I mentioned earlier, we only received two. We still need the other two. So, and we obviously have our tires for them as well. Okay, next box. This is our ECU, AM Infinity 506. Take it out of the packaging for you. So this is our Series 5 506 for 4-cylinder all the way up to 6 cylinders. Comes with typical like USB and cables and so on. Some terminals in there as well. And over here is our flying lead harness. So basically everything is terminated for you. It's got little fuse holder, all the plugs and so on. Like I think this might be for the O2 sensor, your outputs, inputs, some terminals as well. So yeah, we can basically build ourselves a decent looking harness with this, because I mean it's all done already and pinned and everything for you, so makes it much easier. And then we bought some pressure sensors. So I think this we can use for oil pressure. And then we got ourselves another pressure sensor. It's the AM pressure sensor. You probably use this one for fuel or vacuum, doesn't matter. And then the Speed Factory piece is our 4-port boost controller. Here we go. Speed Factory 4-port boost controller. Next box. Again, once again, Speed Factory. This over here is our Speed Factory cap cam. This is a nice piece. So this basically sits behind the shock tower on the EK. Look, they obviously designed this for left-hand drive, so we are obviously most of our cars are right-hand drive, so we'll have to see where we can locate this. Hopefully we can flick it around and then mount it on our passenger sides, because this is obviously you want this logo and stuff to be exposed. And so I'm assuming this was designed for left-hand drive, and this will most likely sit perfectly on our driver sides by the shock tower. But we'll see later when we get the car back here. I mean, overall this is very nice. It's neat, it's clean, it's got three breather filters on top. It's lazy engraved Speed Factory on top there as well, and it's got AN bungs welded on already. I think this is, if I'm not mistaken, -10. So I mean, proper stuff. Okay, we've got some more Speed Factory goodies. This is Speed Factory titanium box for the, I think it's for the transmission. So, transmission bulk kit, all titanium. Stuff is pretty. Can't wait to install these. Okay, so we got ourselves a big box now. So, okay, so this big box is all the way out of the, comes from all the way out of the UK. APL. Fuel cell. So this is our ATL fuel cell. This fuel cell is basically fits into the spare wheel well location on the EK. So at least there's no having to cut or whatever, do any like physical modifications to accommodate us for now with regards to fuel. So yeah, it's like a ABS plastic type of fuel cell. It's got AN fittings for your feeds on top here. There's your return, and then it's got the easy latch canister. It's like baffled on the inside. Got like a little flap, and then the feeds run down towards the bottom of the tank, so it helps with obviously fuel slush and stuff like that. It's a very nice piece. So yeah, 45 liter. Obviously we can't have the fuel cell mounted underneath the car because of our duff and prop and so on, so at least this gets to be mounted inside of the car, and we'll have obviously clearance and so on. Okay, we got ourselves a big boy. Another Speed Factory piece. So this is our Speed Factory intercooler. Comes with a radiator on it as well. This is a definitely a nice looking piece, I'm not gonna lie. Like I said, definitely a very nice piece. And on the back side is your radiator as well. And it's got -16 bungs welded on them as well. I'm assuming this is probably like for a fan switch or something, or your overflow or whatever. And then They supply you with your threaded hoses, your AN fittings, is that 16 fittings for the radiator, as well as the hose, that 16 nylon hose, rubber hose. Spool fans, spool, I don't know how you pronounce them, but proper stuff, proper stuff. So it's two of them, and that mounts straight onto this cowl on the radiator.